So today I'll update you about Nextcloud, specifically the AI feature, which wasn't working anymore with the newer Nextcloud versions. So this is the admin, and I'm using Nextcloud 30, and this is the artificial intelligence section, and as you can see here. So if you go down, this is already working. Okay, so you have to go here to the OpenAI and look at AI integration section. You have to add your Ollama URL ending in V1. You can see what happens here if I change it. Okay, see, if I put something else, it's not going to work. So V1 is the correct endpoint. Okay, and so more or less, this is the same method as before. Nothing really changed here. I just added a few models here. If you can see, it's picking up the models correctly from Ollama. So I created a custom model, but it's based on Open Chat, which I think it's a new model, but it works quite well considering the size. And so this is the easy part, because let's see if I go here with the, okay, here I already had a chat opened. Now we can see when I type in a message and I send it, what happens. Okay, see, it's processing the request, so it arrives to the remote server, and it's going to take maybe a minute or a few seconds, depending on the amount of messages I exchange with the AI. We'll see that at the moment, once the processing on the server finishes, we should get an immediate response. And we'll see how to configure this, but it's easy. Yeah, if you see here, the response arrived once the processing finished on the server. So this is working. Okay. If you go to the Nextcloud official documentation here, let's go to version 30. Okay. In this page, artificial intelligence. So home, if you search for artificial intelligence, it's here. Then you search for improve AI task pickup speed, because this is practically required to have a working environment. So here it says, most AI tasks will run as part of a background job system in Nextcloud, which only runs jobs every 5 minutes by default. To pick up scheduled jobs faster, you can set up background job workers that process AI tasks as soon as they are scheduled. They are saying that in a test environment, you can just run this command, which will create a single task. But if you want something cleaner, you can create a systemd service, which is what I did. You create a service like this. You can just copy this. And then on point two, there is the OCC command to create the task. Now, the first part can be different, especially if you use Docker, like I do, because in that case, or Docker Compose, because in that case, you just need to run the correct Docker Compose command, which you can see in the screen right now. Okay, the command is background job colon worker. Then you have to set a timeout. They're using 60 seconds as timeout, but I used 1 hour, so 3600 seconds. And then if you run the help for that command, you get this. So it says run a background job worker. And the argument, it will be the job class or okay. The classes of the jobs to look for in the database. So that name, which is used here, is encoded in the database. So it's like another cron job thing, an extra thing, which wasn't needed up to Nextcloud 29 included, but from Nextcloud 30, if you want an immediate response from your AI assistant, it's required. Then once you create the script like this, you can create the systemd services. So here they're using a for loop to create 4 instances. I created 12, but it's the same. So it will be for I in 1 to 12, and then it will create 12 Nextcloud AI workers services. And that is it. So remember to visit this page, this paragraph here. So I'll leave it in the video description. It's working fine. Okay, this is still my remote server. It's not running on the same server as Nextcloud, so that's why we had a different IP address. And it's slow because the model is being run on the CPU. I don't have a discrete GPU, but nonetheless, it's working. So I think we can finish the video here. And if you like the video, put a thumbs up as usual and subscribe. And as always, bye-bye.